right if you don't. I'm not afraid of you running away, honey. I get the feeling you owe. There is no sense in pretending. Your eyes give you away. Something inside you is feeling like I do. We said all there is to say.
Drop what you're doing. Make this a priority.
And now, it's time for Guys Not on the Radio with Shap.
He's a party on skates.
And JC.
The little girly man.
Shap.
If you stuck a lump of coal up his ass, in 2 weeks you have a diamond.
And JC.
They think he's a righteous dude.
Is this it? I mean, is this two bowls of M&Ms and some balloons? You know what, Phyllis? I think you need to step it up. Because if I'm not mistaken, we gave you your wedding shower here. We all came into this room and gave you a golden shower.
That's disgusting.
You are fake news.
You're killing me, Smalls.
It's Shap and JC and the Guys Not on the Radio podcast.
Well, that sets up. I'm going to see a man about a wallaby.
It's the Guys Not on the Radio podcast, back again for another exciting edition.
Number 7.
Hey there, how you doing?
I'm doing fantastic.
Don't you know? I got to warn everybody, I'm going to be talking a lot of, like I'm from Minnesota.
Yeah, you got.
Been watching the Fargo.
On TV?
Oh, yeah.
I never got into that show.
I should come smack you, yeah? I mean, it's probably one of the two best shows on TV right now.
What's the other one?
Better Call Saul.
Oh, okay. I'm watching that one.
I haven't watched Mondays yet.
Oh, okay.
Did you watch Monday already?
Probably not. So I love the DVR.
Yeah, I know.
Because it's like, I just binge it. So
Fargo's a good time. The Minnesota. You're the parking lot king of Minnesota. All right, I'm done.
If I knew the show, I would be like, oh my God, Shap, that's hilarious.
We've got an in-studio audience again. We are live on location, or, well, not live really, but, you know. We're recording live in front of people. For those of you watching on Facebook live tonight and then listening on the podcast, like, what is this idiot blabbering on about? But we are at Music Suite 408 today. Thanks to Sue and the gang for letting us use it.
Yes. We're in the Fine Arts Factory.
Yeah, I was going to say, this room has a specific name, yes?
Yes, the Fine Arts Factory,
so,
which is cool. It's like we have a real backdrop this week instead of grandma's furniture and everything else. We're actually on a stage in a location.
Yeah. Apparently, we even got to walk in on a music lesson tonight.
That was awesome.
I know. It was pretty neat. So we'll get to our guest. We have a special guest planned
music.
For tonight. Musically,
live music here.
No radio guest tonight. We have a banquet chair for this person. So, but before we get to our guest, we're not only going to do that, we'll have another edition of Hey Guys, and then we'll have Non-Judgmental Shap. But we got a couple things to get through first. Some big podcast news.
Yes.
Some big Guys Not on the Radio podcast. This has gone over with such huge, swimmingly great success that we've decided to put it on hiatus after tonight.
I'm sorry.
The shocking look on Bobby T's face.
Yeah.
Well, here's the deal. Here's the deal, okay? We're not giving up on the podcast. We're still going to do podcasts. It's just going to be occasionally. We can't guarantee they'll be every week anymore, simply because there's too much crap going on right now. First of all, we got to blame your kids. So, JC's kids, it's their fault.
Blame my kids.
Blame your kids. Because, yeah. Well, you have baseball games 4 nights a week, right?
Yes, we have baseball on Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, Friday. So, Ben has a game Monday and Thursday. Jake has a game Tuesday and Friday. Music lessons on Monday. And then so Wednesday's like my only day.
So that's it.
Then we got weddings on Saturday.
Yeah.
Friday, Saturdays, and then meeting clients.
There's only so much we can do. There's only so much. So as much as we'd love to be able to do it every week, so there's that. And then wedding season, and like you just said, time to schedule these clients.
And Shap just started his job,
I did.
Too.
I just started. So I'm now full-time, and I don't – I'm kind of in this normal 9-to-5 world right about now, you know?
Yeah, so
I told you I'm going to slip into the Minnesota a lot. I'm going in the central time zone thing at 8 to 4, 8 to 4:30 thing. So my time to get stuff done in the afternoon that I usually would have before when I worked in radio isn't there right now. But that's only temporary for this month, because at the end of the month I have non-podcast news, personal news. Shap in the Morning will be back on 95.3 Jack FM starting Tuesday, May 30th, the day after Memorial Day. Yes. Thank you.
Wait, so right now, like, this is going to be like one of the because it's just music right now. So they're going back to a full-fledged morning show.
Full-fledged morning show.
Local and
yes,
live.
Yes, local and live. Which is funny because there are liners that run throughout the day that say things like, we don't have any jocks.
No.
We're playing what we want. So, I had to figure out how to work my way around that. But I kind of break the mold on that a little bit. So, but yeah, it's kind of great because if you listen to 95.3 Jack FM, the imaging Jack, the guy that's Jack who's talking, he's a sarcastic SOB.
So it all works out.
And I'm a sarcastic son of a bitch. So, you know, it just kind of makes perfect sense, you know, for that to kind of go hand in hand, I think. I mean.
Filth.
That's right. So there you go.
Well, congratulations on that, man. It's good to have you back.
I know.
More than just weather.
I know.
Even though I'm going to call and hassle you on that, too.
When I screw up when the weather.
Is it your first day?
I got a text because I recorded a weather at work the one day, and apparently a weather was playing at the time I was recording, so it like cut halfway off in between, and he messaged me. He's like, boy, oh boy, it's your first day in radio, son? You know, like, thanks.
We've all been there.
Dick.
Yeah.
So there you go. There's the news. We will still be continuing, guys, not on the radio podcast. We may have people are saying
we're
going to change
the
name.
Yeah,
or?
Well, I mean, technically, this podcast is not on the radio.
No, so I don't think we need to change the name.
We could still call it that, but
don't stop following us on there. We're still going to do stuff on there. We're still going to.
We're working on. So what we might do next week, I might just do a best of next week or some sort of a compilation, and then. We'll work on trying to find a new schedule.
Are you really trying to say we have best of material?
Of course we do. Every week is best of. Every week.
Okay, let's move on.
All right.
Speaking of best of, I don't know if I would say it's the best one, but Guardians of the Galaxy 2 opens tomorrow, or maybe already now, depending on when you're listening to this thing.
Yes.
The first Guardians was really good.
It was amazing.
I went in with super low expectations. I think I was the last human alive to see the movie. Matter of fact, I think I saw it like a week before I got let go from my job. So I just recently saw it. So and I was really impressed.
Yeah, it is by far, and I love what Marvel has done, because Marvel Studios had to start off with a whole slate of comic book characters that nobody was really familiar
with.
And I mean, your staples were, of course, Hulk and Spider-Man.
Yeah.
And they had Iron Man and Guardians of the Galaxy that they had to work with. And they've made this great franchise. And the movies just get better and better and better every time. So I'm excited.
I'm trying to think if I had to pick a high point so far of all of the Marvel films.
Yeah.
I probably would go the last two Captain America movies. The Winter Soldier one was outstanding.
Yeah.
And then the last one were
Civil War.
Those two were just
props to Doctor Strange, because they worked Interstellar Overdrive from Pink Floyd.
Did they really?
Into that movie.
Do we have
and it was amazing. I'm like yes, cuz that Pink Floyd soundtrack goes so well with. Has anybody seen Doctor Strange? It was really good. So you found it. Well, that's pretty good.
This is a Pearl Jam live cover.
Oh, okay.
Better than nothing.
All right. But the soundtracks, Guardians of the Galaxy first soundtrack was great. Looking at this, I think I was stopped at the music store at the mall the other day and was looking, they had the second soundtrack out, and I was just checking out the track list on it. And they've done really, just good stuff with the just the incorporating music into this franchise.
We DJ'd prom. I DJ'd a prom this past weekend, and I was able to play some of these older songs simply because of Guardians of the Galaxy. So,
but it's just a really good soundtrack.
Pretty neat stuff.
I think Barracuda from Heart's on the soundtrack too.
So this new one, is supposed to have the most hidden scenes, post-credit scenes, than any other Marvel movie. Five scenes.
So you have to sit for five scenes during.
So
the
how
credits.
Long are the credits? Like 15 minutes?
They
then?
Gotta be.
Each scene's usually them. Like what, 45 to 90 seconds or something.
Interesting. Yeah, because Thor was in the cut scene of the credit scene of Doctor Strange.
I know when I forget going to see the first Avengers with Mrs. Schaap in the theater, and we stuck around for the post credit. And it's just like them all wiped out sitting in like some like diner underneath in the subway. And they're just sitting there looking exhausted. And Mrs. Schaap is like, you made me sit here for 10 minutes for that. She did like the movie, though.
Yeah.
She's like, I had to pee. We had to sit for this.
Yeah.
So.
Well, and it's, I mean, Marvel's having a big week, too, because not only is Guardians coming out, they just had the Defenders trailer come out.
Wait, what the
which
hell is
that? I mentioned Iron Fist and how much it sucked.
Oh, is that Iron Fist
the,
part of that?
It's the next, because so they've taken, see, this is my nerd dump coming out as I sit here in my Captain America t-shirt. So, like, they did the first Daredevil, then they did Jessica Jones, and then they did the second Daredevil, and then they did Luke Cage, Iron Fist, and now the four of them are coming together to form the Defenders. And so that's a new series on Netflix, and so now they have...
Will they cross over into the movie universe
see,
or anything else? Will they make it into, like, the Infinity Wars Part 27?
The rumor is that Infinity War is supposed to capture all of the Marvel characters.
Does it include the chick who was on ABC, Agent Carter?
Agent Carter is part of Captain America series.
And oh, that's right, she is.
And then they have Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., which is the in-between between all the Avengers
movies. Do you watch all of this? Including Agent Carter?
So that's why I don't have time to watch Fargo, because I've got Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. and Netflix binging to do.
I am
the comic book guy. I'm sorry. I'm a dork.
Well, you were wearing the captain shirt today, aren't you?
I am. So anyway, if that's the comic
time
book
he gets
news.
To be captain in his life.
That is so true.
Well, you're married, so there you go. So there you go. Guardians of the Galaxy 2.
Yes.
Probably going to be one of the top five biggest movies of the year.
Probably. So. Unless Justice League comes out, I don't know. Nobody's going to watch
it. That's not this year, is it?
Yeah, it is. Justice League comes out in November. It's going to go probably up against Thor.
And then the next month, Star Wars will come and just be like, I'm going to whip out my lightsaber and cut you all up.
Yeah.
That's it. I was going to say something else, but lightsabers seem like appropriate metaphor.
That works for all of it.
And nothing else whipping out. So, all right. Speaking of whipping out,
was the best transition ever into what you're going to go into.
I know, especially because the next study that there's a new survey out. All right, those people that like to make those surveys, trying to figure out what the sex bases actually are. You know how you when you tell somebody, you know, when you're growing up and you're like in high school and you're like, oh, did you make it to first base? Yeah, second base, all that other stuff. So what exactly are the bases? So the survey was sent out and here was what people described.
Should we invite our special guest up to join us for this one?
I don't know. Does our special guest teach small children? Will their parents be watching? So I don't know. It's up to him if he wants to, you know, weigh in. He said, go ahead. He said, go ahead. He'll wait on that. So, I mean, we do have an in-studio audience, so you could always ask them, too.
Yeah, true.
So, but here is the most popular definition of the bases, according to people throughout the world. All right? First base is kissing, either with or without tongue. Second base, touching privates, like boobs in the butt, but no genitalia. No genitalia.
Okay.
All right.
Well, you said private, so I was like, wait, hold on.
I guess
boobs
in the butt.
But it's private.
Yeah.
Okay.
So third base, hands to the genitalia. Although more than one-third of people think it's also using the mouth in that area.
That's third base?
That's third. Only a third of people
say say like you're sliding into home there.
Face first, right?
Yeah, probably, yeah. That's you're almost there.
And then home run you finally.
Okay.
It's yes. full-on penetration.
See, I didn't go to Catholic school, so we didn't really talk about the bases too much.
No.
Three out of four people All say right. they learned about the bases from their friends or from TV.
Okay.
And less than 1% learned from their parents. Thank God.
Yeah. That would be an awkward conversation.
Yeah.
So. Like, I feel weird about it right now, thinking that my mom and dad might be watching this as I talk about it.
I remember when I was, it was a summer in Iowa
yeah.
with my older cousin telling me.
Your cousin told you about the bases.
I think it might have been my older cousin's friend, actually.
Yeah. Who gave you the speech?
Yeah. She gave me the speech.
Nice.
Yes. That's
Did she show you the bases?
No. No.
Yeah, some training.
No. So.
It's a batting practice.
No, that didn't happen.
Did you ever get the talk, though? Did your mom ever give you the talk? Or your dad? Do you remember that?
I think so.
Yeah?
I think so.
Yeah. Yeah, but you're not quite sure? Yeah. Because I got the talk. But the talk was this. I was in high school, had a girlfriend over. The door was closed.
Oh, boy.
My dad came back. He opened the door. He goes, the door needs to stay open. After she left that night, he looked at me. He goes, I'm going to tell you one thing and one thing only. Keep it in your pants. And that was it. That was the whole talk. That was it.
Oh, that's great, Ken. That's outstanding.
That's it.
I remember having the leave the door open. I remember that happened a few times.
Yeah.
Leave the door open.
But you know what? I listened to my dad. I kept it in my pants until I was married.
What?
Right?
Okay. Okay, yeah, sure. Sure, whatever you want to say, JC. Whatever you want to say.
Just in case they're watching.
Yeah. All right. So there you go. That's what the people in America have to say about the bases. Anyone in the peanut gallery care to comment? No?
You wanted...
So that was clear. That helped our special guest to get clarification.
Oh, so we were educational tonight.
Yes.
Holy cow.
So can you classify this? I know usually you
I
have
can
to
change
put extreme
the definition.
Content. You can put it as educational.
Educational.
So there you go.
So maybe kids should be watching. We could be learning.
I don't know if we'll go.
Uncle Shap and JC.
There you go.
With the educational podcast.
Keep it in your pants, kids. Keep it in your pants.
Oh, boy.
And now, Tales from Radioland.
All right, Tales from Radioland. We have no guests for Radioland today, so it's just stories of JC and me. And we're actually going to start with something that recently happened in JC's neck of the woods where he grew up. So
yeah.
Right in the same, close to the same town where he was told to keep it in his pants, something bad happened actually in Radioland.
Yeah, it's crazy because like I don't know if you know, I'm originally from Sterling Rock Falls area, if you guys ever been up there. I started my radio career there in 1994, 95. And
you started in high school.
I did. I was like 15, 16 years old. Worked as an intern at WSDR, WSSQ, WZZT, and had
give them all.
Just
give them
that's
all.
It. Hey, it was good. It was good times. I learned a ton. And recently, the station got bought. Now I know in the time I was there during the 2 years I was there, it was sold once. No, twice. It got sold twice. And the company that had it, Withers Broadcast, just sold it off to another company. And recently, the morning show is actually people that I started working with there. So these people
really?
Had been
still
on the
there,
air,
huh?
Had been on the air for over 20 years.
Wow, that's
awesome. And I started with Kathy Wagner, who was the sports director there, and she interned while I was there. And then we had Mary Carlson, who did news, who actually taught me quite a bit of things about working in a newsroom when I was in high school. And she was doing news there. And then also Brian Zishi, who is one of the funniest and most talented radio guys that I ever had a chance to work with. And all three of them were doing the morning show together. And all three of them made announcements on Facebook this week that they made a choice to leave the station.
They made a choice,
They made
huh?
a choice to leave the station, which when they all three make the choice to leave the station at the same time makes you kind of go, okay, what's really going on here? But it is a... It's a huge loss to the legacy of that station. I hope the new owners do respect the traditions that that station has been for the community. Just like CMY is a staple,
yeah.
LPO is a staple,
yeah.
SDR is a staple for the Sterling Rock Falls area.
They're the full service ones that are always
These
ones that stay on your grandma's kitchen all day.
Yeah.
Those are the stations.
Well, my favorite story, Brian Zishi, when I was probably 16, 17 years old, who's doing mornings on the Classic Rock station when I worked there. I'd go and sit with him and we'd chat and stuff. And one of my favorite bits he ever did was, and we got in trouble for it. He was like, "You ever eat it at Long John Silver's?" And I'm like, "No." He's like, "Well," he's like, "I don't even order off the menu anymore. I just say, give me $5 worth." And I'm like, what do you mean, give me $5 worth? He's like, "They just fry it all together and it all tastes the same. So I just go in and give me $5 worth." And I'm just rolling while he's doing this whole bit about it. And afterwards, turn off the mic. The station manager walks down the hall and he knocks on the door and Ryan answers it. And he goes, "You cannot say that about potential sponsors on the air." And he's like, I don't see Long John Silver's ever spend any money with me. Give me $5 worth.
$5.
But yeah, he's just, real quick witted guy. Just, it is a loss to, I think, to the Sterling area. Hey, also, Kathy had been doing sports for over 20 years since she got out of high school.
Wow.
And, so one of the best female broadcasters, one of the best sports broadcasters I ever had a chance to work with.
Well, I'm sure, and when you're in the business that long, because they could still have that choice of, do they want to continue in the industry?
Sure.
Or do they want to say, maybe now it's time to
go on
and
do something
else?
Yeah, and the thing about working in this business is it gives you so many different skills.
Yeah, you give a lot of different skills, and you also, especially if you're a small market, the money is,
Yeah.
So, you have that choice. You start thinking about that. You got family, you got kids, all that other stuff. You know this all too well.
Yeah.
So.
Hours suck.
Shh.
All right.
So, that's your Tales from Radio Land.
That's my Tales from Radio. I just, I'm going to miss them, hearing them when I come home and visit the folks and get to flip on SDR and listen to those voices. It's going to be a big loss. So. There's some big shoes that whoever comes in next has to fill up there.
So you went to early in your radio career for Tales from Radio Land. I'll go to early in my radio career for my Tales from Radio Land. I'm going back to college radio, which is where I first met JC. So
yes,
at WONC on the campus of North Central College. You think I still even remember? Was it 630-637-8989?
That is it.
There you go. That's the number.
Still works.
Yep, still does. So FM 89 from classics to the cutting edge, and I have two quick stories.
Okay,
the first one, I think it was freshman year of college, we launched a show called The Loony Bin.
Yes,
with a couple friends of ours, Brad and Dan. Which was Dan automatically known as the Nad? Was he automatically known as the Nad?
I don't remember.
I think he was automatically the Nad. But we gave away a date with me on the radio. Do you remember
that?
Oh,
that's right.
Oh, what a horrible idea that was.
Didn't the Wolf guys just do that?
Yes, they did.
Wait, no,
but
they,
it wasn't
they
with
matched,
them.
They matched people
yes,
up.
Yes, they
okay,
matched.
Never mind.
So, which, by the way, good luck to both of those fellas. They're moving on to different pastures as well.
Yeah.
They just officially announced that on social media this week.
Wow.
So. So good luck to both of them, Rob and Sean. But no, we gave away a date with me on the radio, and I remember we had to go to the Toilet Bowl of America, Aurora, which is what our nickname
That's right.
was for Aurora, the Toilet Bowl of America.
Oh, boy.
To pick up this girl and her friends, and they were in high school, so that was really bad.
But that wasn't the first time that we went on a date with a high school girl while you were in college.
I think it was. I think that was the first time, actually. So, because that was
that
freshman
off,
year. That was freshman year of college.
That kicked off
a trend. Thank you. So,
now I date older women. I'm married to an older one. So
yeah,
there you go.
Yeah.
It's
good that you clarified
yeah,
that.
Great. Well, even great that I say older because now she's just gonna hit me. So.
Well, I just thought
she's
that
older
was
by me like by a year. So there you go.
But you said you dated older women and then had to clarify that. No,
well,
no.
I did. Let's move on.
I know. I just
Let's
was like,
on.
Are you trying to get yourself in trouble?
Where's
or what?
The shovel? Come on. Just dump it on me. So
you went on a date with a girl, a high school girl, while you were in college.
Yeah, that was.
You earned on the college radio station.
Yes. Yes.
Okay.
Didn't Mad Dog call us out about that?
Yeah, you probably got banned from radio for like
no,
6 months.
No, I didn't. Not for that. I got banned for cussing on the air. That's what I got banned for like one term. So.
All right.
The second story I have is from senior year of college. and I was hosting a vintage rock show, which is at night. We would play that's from 64 to 74. So, you know, you'd play a lot of long songs. So I would bring my own catalog music. I'd be playing like a 13-minute Led Zeppelin song because I think it was a Friday night. So it was like Led Zeppelin's 4x4. So you'd play four songs in a row from Led Zeppelin. And so I'm outside having a cigarette. And all of a sudden, and I was with a friend, Cassie, who frequently tunes into the podcast. So we're out there, and this guy who we don't recognize comes storming up the sidewalk, just comes storming up. And I'm like, can I help you? And there was two doors. There was like the outside door, and then there was a locked door on the inside where you had to like get buzzed in for security. And he goes up to this door, the security door, which was unlocked because I was outside smoking. And he starts pounding and banging the shit out of this door. Just going crazy, all right? Eventually, I'm like, I don't know what to do. I can't get in. I mean, this guy was enraged. Like, I thought he was, like, on something, okay? He eventually took a chair and broke the piece of glass, plated glass, in between the door and broke it. And got in the station. So
He got in?
He got in. Oh, yeah, he got in.
Because I thought, like, he broke the window.
Did he break it with his hand?
He started pounding the door with his hand, and he broke his hand.
He did take the chair, because the chair was broke, too.
Yeah, but I thought he never actually got into the building.
No, he made it in the building.
Because the door was unlocked the whole time.
Yes, the door was unlocked the whole time.
So he's banging the door with the chair in his fist,
yeah.
And the door was unlocked the whole time.
So I went and ran around to the back door, because I had a key, and Cassie and I go to the back, and We get in the building, and I turn around, and I get down the hallway, and I see the glass shards laying all over the place and blood.
Yeah.
And this guy is nowhere to be found. So, like, I'm freaking out. And I don't even remember who my first call was. I think I called campus security right away.
Yeah.
I think I called campus security right away.
And they called the police.
And then I remember you guys were at a party in the with 409, the 409 crew, because you were the PD of the station.
Yeah.
And a friend of ours, Greg Burks, was the station manager, and he comes down, and the first thing he says to me, he's like, I gotta know, did you push the emergency call button under the board? There was like an emergency button.
Yeah.
You know, like banks have the emergency buttons to call if they're getting robbed. And I'm like, no. I was outside smoking.
Yeah, because he walked right past you, and he started doing his stuff.
And
then you went around to the back.
Yeah, I'm very proud of this. No dead air. 13 minutes of Led Zeppelin's No Quarter played during the whole thing. I got back in to change the song. And I think they ended up catching the guy somewhere else on campus then.
Yeah.
And apparently he heard a song earlier in the day on the radio. And he lived like, probably 15 miles away from the place. He lived in another town. And he walked there. Walked there the whole way. He heard a song on there, and I don't even know what the song is, but it's from the Hedwig and the Angry Itch soundtrack, and there's a lyric in the song that says, "Don't you know me, babe, I'm the new Berlin Wall, try and tear me down," and that offended him to no end. So he went shit and walked to the station to attack me.
Wow.
To this day.
I thought the story was that he actually had a mental issue.
He did.
He had a caretaker. Yeah, exactly.
He did.
Obviously,
he did.
Right?
Yeah, he did.
Yeah,
he had a mental issue, but that was the song. That was.
And so the song set him off. He didn't take his medication that day.
I had to go to court for that.
It was over.
I got called to the court for to testify for that.
Wow.
And they
throw it out or
his judge or his lawyer postponed the trial, asked for a postponement, and then I think they settled. So,
oh, okay.
Because I never got asked to come back.
All right.
So there you
go. That's crazy.
That's my wild and crazy tales from Radio Land.
That's amazing. You've never been attacked on the local airwaves.
No, not yet. Not yet. There's been some other things, but not
just
that.
Wait.
Just I think we should bring up our guest.
Yes.
What do you think? Should we bring up our guest?
Yes.
Let's bring up our guest, please. Welcome to the stage, Mr. Kevin Kramer. I should have some sort of applause here for you in the. I just have Lady Gaga's applause. That's all I have.
Oh no, that's not good.
What's up, man? How are you?
Doing pretty good. I've been here at West Clocks all day, So
you're ready to go home, and now you're like, I got to do this podcast.
Yeah, then we like clown.
It's cool. It's good to be here, guys. I appreciate the invite.
Yeah, well, thank you for having us in your like work environment.
Look, you even got a suit jacket on today.
This is just like everyday attire for me.
Nice. Nice.
Well coiffed. Got the suit jacket. He's good to go.
So. Oh, I have to tell you, good recommendation. I went and saw, I was talking to Kevin the other day. His buddies are in a movie. I watched The Butcher, the Bakers.
Oh, yeah.
Saw it at the Roxy, and I just saw they got expanded to the Streeter one. And
yeah,
you did,
Eagle
you,
6.
You did music for the Hometown Productions before, didn't you?
Yeah, one I did a song movies? For Grace's Room, which is the movie they made last year, and for River City Panic. Did a couple songs for both of those.
That's pretty cool.
So do you just record a song, or do you actually like get to watch the movie while you're noodling away at the guitar to do score?
Grace's Room, they sent me like a preliminary copy, and I watched most of it and kind of used that for some lyrical inspiration and for mood of the song. River City Panic, I was just winging it.
There you go.
Which I think that was kind of their thing that with that movie, too.
Yeah, yeah. Well, and the thing is I saw River City Panic. I haven't seen Grace's Room yet, but what they've done with Butcher the Baker is, like, you know, timing-wise, production value, it is outstanding.
How long of a movie is it? Is it a full-length feature?
Yeah, And it's playing at Streeter Eagle 6 through next week. I think they got expanded at Roxy,
too. Yeah, I think they're doing one more week at Roxy, yeah.
But, yeah, definitely cool. Sean Walsh, who you worked with, and good, he was in a band with you, too, is one of the lead characters in the movie, so...
I want to just quickly give a shout-out to the Roxy and the Eagle 6 for showing it. That's very awesome that they did that, because you just don't hear about things like that too
often. Yeah, to support local artists
it's great.
Is huge.
Great.
And the fact that they're doing that even on the movie scene. The amount of talent, I think, that comes out of this area is just it's just amazing. And, Kevin, we're lucky we kind of stumbled on you, because we met you at a wedding.
Yeah, at a wedding. You were playing... Was it Paige?
Paige and Matt.
Yeah, yeah. Paige and Matt Ebner. Yeah. It was their wedding. I DJ'd the wedding, and you were there for cocktail hour, right? Were you doing
planned for the ceremony, actually.
You did ceremony only? Okay. And then you didn't do anything else after the ceremony?
Nope. I just came up and talked to you. I was like, hey, do you guys need any help?
That's right. Then I'm like, well, sure, why not? So, and now we've so he DJ'd for us for a couple of seasons, and
he still kind of DJs.
He still kind of does it, but we kind of...
I'm the resident musician.
That's
yeah,
right.
Yeah,
guys on the radio.
So unbelievably talented musically, which you're going to get to see on the people watching the video, and even here on the podcast too.
And before we get going, like, what's your background in music, and how'd you get involved? I know you played in quite a few bands, like through high school, and now like just doing a ton of awesome stuff here at the factory at Music Suite. But I mean, what was the bug for you that got you in? What got you going?
Well, the first official instrument I guess I played in school was a recorder, which you guys probably played recorder too.
Hot cross buns.
Yeah, exactly.
Hot cross buns.
Exactly. Yeah, so I was like,
hot cross buns.
Exactly. So that was like in school, it's like in class, it's like everyone's in their own desk doing their own, getting their own grades. And in sports, it's like everyone has their own teams. But with music, it was like everyone's doing the same thing. Everyone's playing the same song. So I think even at a younger age, that just had a certain appeal to me. I started playing trumpet and then just kind of gravitated to guitar and drums. I specifically remember being in seventh or eighth grade. I saw the music video for Smells Like Teen Spirit.
And
it just like lit this spark in me. And I just, like, knew that I had to get a guitar and start playing. and I mean, I had heard Nirvana before that, and I remember, like, seeing the cassette tape of Nevermind. And I don't have headphones on.
That's all right.
So it was kind of Nirvana kind of launched you in?
That song and video just like really struck a nerve with me, and I had wanted to start playing earlier in my life too. But
you mean so that video didn't inspire you to want to go out and be a janitor? Because you know the old guy with the mop.
Okay,
that's all right. It's a poor joke. I know. I'm sorry. How old were you when Nirvana came?
I mean, in '91, I was like five or six years old.
And you saw the video. when you were that young?
I saw it in eighth grade, so I was about 13, 14. So Kurt had already been dead.
Yeah.
And, you know, that just kind of left this gaping hole in music, which I think the corporate music people tried to fill that with Nickelback a few years later. Like that to me, like when I hear Nickelback, it's like it's like Chad Kroeger is their Kurt Cobain.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because it's just like, I'm not going to say much more about it, but
you don't. Well, I'll tell you what, because that dude is liable to like tweet you back.
He probably, because you know, whenever anybody trashes him socially,
Chad Kroeger does it.
Yes.
Really?
Yeah. Is it Chad Kroeger?
I mean, it is.
So all
what,
I gotta
is
do
is
tweet him, and he'll yell at me.
Seriously.
All right.
Well, I mean, I think you have to be like somebody famous, because Arnold Schwarzenegger.
What are you saying?
Arnold Schwarzenegger did that thing about more popular than Congress.
Okay.
And it was like hemorrhoids and all. Hemorrhoids more popular than Congress. Nickelback more popular than Congress. Well, Chad Kroeger and Nickelback tweeted him back and be like, did you really have to include us in there? Like, that was kind of a dick thing to do.
Yeah.
And Schwarzenegger tweeted back and he's like, thanks for calling me out.
Yeah,
I appreciate
it. And who else did that to him too? Facebook guy. Zuckerberg did.
Oh, he did that.
He made fun of him too, and they got mad.
I'm making fun of you, Chad.
Why do we have to make fun? Why do we have to make fun of Nickelback so much? Why can't it be Creed?
Oh, hey, Scott Stapp. Scott Stapp deserves it. All right. Then again, maybe we need to lay off poor Scott Stapp.
Really?
No.
Okay.
No.
All right.
So yeah,
I'm a little concerned. Bob Tiemann's like
are you
all
mad?
Stirred
are
up
you
about
mad
this.
About Creed?
I love Creed.
Oh my god!
I love Creed.
You really?
I mean, there's a time and a place. There's a time and a place for everything. And if that music hits you at a time in your life when it meant something to you, more power to you.
I was in the midst of deep production today at the WCMY WRKX studios. And the door was open, and through my headphones, I overhear one of the members of the staff, Sean Fry.
Yeah.
Was talking, and it wasn't to me, but I just heard him talking down the hall, and I heard him start just going off on Pearl Jam. He's like, they haven't had a good album since, like, 96. He's like, all they play is music from the early 90s when they play live concerts. They don't play anything from their new stuff. He's like, they're just, you know why they don't? Because all their new stuff sucks. That's why. And
he in the crowd goes, I like this guy. You don't like Pearl Jam?
Oh, my Uh-oh. God. You might have to leave the room, Uh-oh. Dude. I jumped up out of my chair in the studio, and I said, hey, you might want to keep your mouth shut. Those are fighting words around this part. I said, I've seen Pearl Jam 22 times, and all of a sudden there was, like, silence. So, and he's like, did you really like their new music? He's like, you're the only person I've ever talked to that likes any of their new music. And I says, I think that 20,000+ people every night would beg to differ with you when they play, but that's okay. So, so then we had a little discussion about music and found out that he's been to exactly one concert in his life. So the moral of the story is that I need to take Sean to a concert or two so he can see some more shows.
Yeah.
So, definitely. So there you go. So, yeah. Don't be trashing the Jam. So, I'm sorry. Maybe I shouldn't trash the Creed. So, there
or
you go.
Or Nickelback. We shouldn't trash any music,
there's
right?
We shouldn't.
Yeah. So, big thing on Facebook this week that some people, speaking of trashing, we got trashed because we participated. So, apparently, you participate, you get yelled
at.
Oh,
yeah, we did. We got trashed for participating.
Yes.
That's right.
There was a thing where you post 10 bands that you've seen and one that you are lying about, and then you're inviting your friends to guess which ones. I thought the whole
Awesome.
The exercise was to show your friends that you've seen bands like Creed and Nickelback, and then they'd be like, "Oh my goodness, you saw Creed and Nickelback."
And it was I'm all for about having fun things on Facebook and not like politics or just
If we could talk
about
each
other,
yes.
Yeah, and what ended up happening out of this? You post 10 bands, 9 I've seen, 1 I haven't, and what do? You still got trashed for it.
You just gave away your password secrets.
Exactly. Oh, yeah.
You're going to get hacked.
I never use bands for my password secrets. So my thought was, since you know you're a musician, that you might have some bands that might surprise us that we wouldn't be able to guess. How about we just do three? Kevin, can you name three bands?
I think he's got
actually,
a list.
Yeah, I sat down and made a list earlier.
Kevin's got 10.
He did prepped.
All right, here we go.
All right, so here's my 10. One I have not seen. So.
Okay.
All right.
AC/DC, Less Than Jake, Muse, Silverchair, Streetlight Manifesto, Bob Dylan, RX Bandits, Circa Survive, The Wailers, Bela Fleck and the Flecktones.
Oh, that's a good one.
And so we have to guess which one you haven't
seen. One I have not seen. And I realize a couple of those are kind of obscure. A few of them are obscure. I've been to a lot of smaller kind of random shows, but yeah, I'm interested to hear what y'all might guess.
The Wailers.
I actually...
Didn't you play with the Wailers?
Yeah, I played on stage with the Wailers.
Dang.
Yeah.
All right, does anyone in the audience want to guess first before I make mine?
AC/DC.
That was my first concert. United.
Really?
Yes. Nice. So that was another early catalyst for me. Smells Like Teen Spirit. Seeing AC/DC at the United Center, 14 years old.
Oh, yeah, that will do it.
Yeah.
That will do it. All right.
Silverchair?
Silverchair, I saw Lollapalooza 2007.
Do you have it marked on your list, the band, or no? Or can I just look at the list? It won't give it away, will it?
No.
I'm going to go with Dylan.
Ding, ding, ding,
there
ding,
you
ding,
go.
Ding,
Dylan.
Ding, ding. I have not seen Bobby D.
I have heard Bob Dylan is either amazing or he's awful.
I've heard the same.
He's one of those artists that he's either just on and it's great or he just doesn't give a shit.
His guitarist, Charlie Sexton, came to Columbia Music Department when I was going to school there.
Did Charlie tell you that himself? Like, man,
well,
Bob,
just wait.
Sometimes he smokes too much weed and he sucks.
I mean, he had some really interesting musical things to say. I don't know. It was more about, like, him playing in Bob's band than Bob himself.
Yeah.
He said that he's, like, a huge, like, music historian, that he just has, like, such a huge library of music.
Oh, yeah.
That's one of the things I remember.
Dylan's has so many albums.
Well, like, his own albums, but then, like, his collection of other people's music, too. Mm-hmm. I'm sure it's...
Now, you've worked, like, you mentioned Bela Fleck and the Flecktones. I know you know Victor Wooten, right?
Yeah.
And he's the one of the most amazing bassists I've ever seen.
Ever, live. Yeah, absolutely.
Well, don't you go to his, like, he has a camp, right?
Yeah, he
like
does these music and nature camps about an hour outside Nashville. And it's, like, this schedule they put out every year. And it's open to anybody. So, I mean, I've met people from all over the world going to those. And, yeah, just some really amazing people. And Victor has a really amazing family, too. Like, all his brothers play music. And
yeah, his brother's Future Man, who's got the synth,
the drum
thing.
Which has been a big inspiration for the guitar you're going to see me play here in a little bit with the drum pads on it. And then his other brother, Joseph Wooten, plays keys in the Steve Miller Band.
Oh,
really?
Which is kind of cool, yeah.
That is awesome.
Oh, yeah.
I had no idea. Yeah. Hey, is he original keyboardist?
No, since about like 93.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
How long ago did you see Muse?
Ooh, that was another Lollapalooza.
Oh, Lala show?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, they were 07, that's right, because I think I went... the last night of that one, because it was Pearl Jam headline the last night. I think Muse was like the first night of the thing. So we saw Muse last year?
Yeah.
They were really good.
Fantastic.
It was an amazing light show. And we didn't even get the full show, because they had the last song they did was a drones thing. So they had drones like flying around, or they were supposed to have drones flying around.
But they had technical difficulties.
And they were having technical difficulties with them, so they just sat on their pods all night.
Yeah,
but, I mean, it was still cool. They had a lot of other cool, neat tricks and stuff.
That's
and
cool.
So spectacle. They were one of those bands that not only do you get the amazing musical talent, but you get the spectacle with it as well. Some bands just specialize in spectacle and not so much music, and they definitely give you both. So.
Now, do you want to go ahead and get Kevin set up, play some tunes for us?
Well, I think before we do that, let's just... matter of fact, can you grab your guitar and just bring it over here so you can just kind of explain it? I'll hold that microphone for you while you do that, just so you can kind of explain, because you got a really interesting rig here. You've got extra strings on it. You've got a DJ pad on it and more. So we're not going to have him. I don't think he's going to plug in quite yet.
Well, you know what? If you want to have him stand over there and use his mic, it's live, people. It's somewhat live.
Yeah.
All right. Jim Van Fleet did some of the work on that.
Yeah. So
he's a local musician. We used to work with him in radio, actually.
So you've got how many strings on that? Seven?
So, yeah, I have an extra bass string on here. Because, yeah, hanging out at Victor Wooten's camp, it's like you start to appreciate the bass frequencies a little bit more.
And how did you rig all this yourself? Did you create it yourself?
So initially I bought a guitar from Terry up at Guitar Junkyard for $120 just because I wanted to try this idea out.
Yeah.
So that was my first prototype. I'm calling this one my second prototype. And I wanted to be able to play drums, bass, and guitar on the same instrument. So
yeah, here's my trying to get a nice close up of it, but I think you'll get another chance when he's playing live a little bit too. So
yeah, so I got my bass string here.
It's awesome.
And then the rest of it is just like a guitar and drop D tuning. And then back here, this little artist palette looking thing. These are my drum sounds. So I got, I turned the volume down on that, but you'll see it in a minute. So, see, bass drum, snare drum, hi-hat, crash cymbal. And
they look like little felt pads you'd put on the bottom of your furniture so that you don't scratch your floor.
That's actually exactly what they are. And it works great. So
Is that the crazy genius that is Jim Van Fleet that came up with that?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. Which he's building like a DJ table for you guys, right? A custom DJ table. Yeah. I'm excited to see how that turns out as well.
Awesome.
Yeah, and like I haven't even really delved into what I can do with this as much as I would have liked to, because I can set these to have to sample anything. So
you can have it like Flavor Flav's. Yeah,
exactly,
boy.
Exactly. And I'm really, really, really excited to delve into that.
So what are the two? You got two jacks coming out then. So, yeah, is it one for the drums, and one for the guitar?
Guitar, exactly.
Gotcha. And then you plug it all into a loop board.
Loop station, yep.
And then so you can loop your drums, loop your bass. Loop your rhythm
guitar, and then sing and play lead.
That's amazing. So
it's fun.
And by the way, you put my camera on for a second. Put my camera on for a second. You can book him for your wedding through Guys on the Radio. Just go to guysontheradio.com today. He could play your ceremony. He could play your cocktail. Or he could play your dinner.
He could play
your reception.
The
even.
Whole damn reception.
He could, technically.
We've been talking about doing some sort of a live/DJ thing where we he sends samples and I send samples back to him, and we'll have to figure that out.
Let's do it.
You know, I think it'd be awesome.
I think we're ready to see Kevin play live too. Right. So we're gonna get this all set up here on the Guys Not on the Radio podcast with Kevin Kramer. You got any gigs? Before we get there, gigs and stuff coming up. You got any gigs coming up you want to mention, or bands that you got, shows you got? Because I mean, you're in what, Ahimsa, which is mainly you, right?
Yeah, at this point, it's kind of me and various people. There's been a lot of friends that have helped out with the project. And I have an album that I'm about to put out with that project, and there's a ton of different musicians on it and production people that have helped with it. But yeah, I do a lot of solo gigs too. I'm playing at the Pink Chihuahua in Ottawa Friday, Cinco de Mayo, so I'll be playing some Latin grooves.
Nice.
There. I'm playing with this big band Saturday up in Winnebago. They're called Class Act. Class Winnebago. Act Big Band.
Oh, yeah, they're from Sterling, right?
Up that way.
Yeah.
I think so, yeah.
Yeah, I think some of my buddies might have played in that one, too. So, yeah, I know Class Act. So, yeah, that's cool.
So that's
good. They're good people.
They are.
Yeah.
That's this weekend.
That's cool.
All right, well, I can't wait to see you in action, because this is the first time I've seen you with the drum pad with the moving felt tips. So,
thank you guys so much.
Yeah, we're looking forward to seeing it. So Kevin Kramer, we're going to get him all set up, and we're going to get some video going of that, too. I am the Guys on the Radio podcast.
Do you want to play a little ditty while we get him set up?
You want to let Jack and Diane?
Yeah, that sounds good. Sure, whatever.
I'm just saying.
So little ditty?
Little ditty about Jack and Diane.
Yeah, so I can just sing it.
Two American kids growing up in the heartland.
Yep.
Yeah, there you go.
All right.
Jack and Diane, two American kids growing up in the heartland.
I think we're just about ready here, or we're getting there.
Oh, football star, Diane's debutante backseat of Jackie's car.
What are you saying, JC? What are you saying? I was going to give you the microphone, so.
Sucking on chili dog, outside taste freeze. Yep.
We got him running through the board. Here's Kevin Kramer, everybody.
Waxing, waning. Don't deny the prize inside your eye, you'll find it. You could run and you could hide, but you could never get away. Being right here in the moment is just the only way. I was going to come and do the show last week and have just been getting over this this springtime cold, which kind of caught up with me a little bit there. But I'm playing a few songs from the album that's going to be coming out, which these are obviously the live versions of the songs. They sound a little bit different on the recording. But I'm going to do a tune that has a little bit more of a reggae groove to it. It's called Let You In. We'll be right back.
you in, let you into where I live, wondering, wondering who ever knew everything that we've been through, and if it ever made a difference that I stay true. If I lied, would you try to deny me entry into paradise so I can be free? Have I forgotten and I need reminding? Helping other people doesn't work if they're not trying to help themselves rise up out of a hellhole and realize the spirit in our lives is so whole. Are we just feeling separated because of egos? Get yourself together, plant a tree and watch us all grow. And if I sound like I'm down to the earth now, you know I got to say just what it's worth. And if you got to place one body back in the ground, see the fire lit inside you is divine, it never goes out. Fire burns, emerges with the sun. Wake up and see that everyone made of a reflection of the one species. Life is such a precious thing, it's meant for more than pleasing. I let you in, let you in, let you into where I live, wondering, wondering who ever knew everything that we've been through, and if it ever made a difference that I say. You out of your mind. Thanks. So, let's see. Some people say that that Ahimsa is a reggae band. There's some reggae-inspired grooves, but I play all kinds of music, so I've been pretty inspired by Latin grooves too. I'm gonna do one that's got kind of a Latin groove to it. Cause I maybe didn't mention earlier in the podcast that I've spent a lot of time on drums as a drummer. Obviously, if I'm on drums, I'm a drummer. So that has just influenced my how I think about music a lot. And still to this day, I teach drum lessons also. And if you need a drummer for a gig, let's talk about it. But this one is called Telltale Sign of an Artist. Struggling
never take a step outside your bubble. Better know love is coming to get you. In the rhythm of the never-ending soul groove, are you smiling and happy to see me? Do you have what it takes to really be free? Nothing here is what I've been controlling, ever evolving and changing and growing into what I make, what I am fed with, as I'm dealing with the woman who I bred with. Made a life, human rights, consciousness lift. I'm not changing the subject, just don't want to diss. I got better things to do than be negative. Got to use my mind and think of ways that I can give back to everything the planet's been providing. I would rather go deaf than hear you lying. So tell me the truth. How it just flies by, rhyme all the lines, lyrically not a shy guy. Say what's on my mind, don't hide the good feeling. Rhythm in my life, vibrations are healing. Dream of a world at one with itself. Imagine all the people rising up out of their own hell. Tell me about what you want, your desire. Is a fantasy like a liquor burning fire? Tell me the truth.
Outstanding job, Kevin. Thank you very much, man. Good stuff there.
Really. Right on, guys.
Kevin Kramer, you can see him. Was so that's all Ahimsa stuff that you were
Yeah, that's original music. I put it out under Ahimsa, yeah. Which is kind of a yoga word. I just put a little musical spin on it. But it's pretty much like, you know, the opposite of doing harm.
Yeah.
Because one good thing about music, when it hits, you feel no pain, right?
So when you're doing that stuff, because you got the loop pedal, and then is that other pedal like kind of a, does it kind of layer your voice, basically?
Yeah,
your
this is the harmony singer pedal.
That's awesome.
Uh-huh.
Crazy. So that when you, so I noticed like you're doing like a foot dance, because I know if I was up there doing that, I would have fallen on my face like 8 times.
Yeah. I
should. Have you fallen at all doing this?
I've almost definitely had some close calls.
And that is, I notice you close your eyes almost every time when you're singing. Ooh. Is that pretty normal?
Yeah, it just depends. It just depends.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's like if I'm just really needing to like get into it.
Yeah. Yeah.
In my brain, think about like, you know, when I wrote the song, you know, where I was at,
yeah,
at that point, you know, and try and connect with that.
Yeah, that last song was great. I mean, all three of them were great, but that last song, you know, knowing a little bit about you and your story and everything else, and yeah, definitely could tell. So yeah, really cool stuff though.
Thank you guys so much.
Really, really blessed to have you part of our Guys of the Radio team, and blessed that you were able to come and be on the Guys Not on the Radio podcast tonight.
Yeah, thank you guys again so much.
Thank you, Kevin. We got a couple. We get ready to wrap up the show.
Yeah, we could do that.
Yeah, we're gonna wrap up the show with our guys with our non-judgmental Shap stuff here, and then Kevin.
Bob's got you got something, Bob.
Bob, yeah. Bob
CD's
wants to know when we
out.
Get the CD. Yeah, so
that's what. Yeah,
there you go. Where can we get that CD?
So,
at, Kevin?
For the first time in my life, I'm actually going to have physical CD copies
printed. Really?
So there'll be physical CDs. Because, I mean, I have a CD player in my car. I still listen to CDs. So we're working on that. Jeff, right next door at Audio Out here, is helping me out with that. And then I'm going to go with some digital distribution with it, so it should be on Spotify, iTunes,
all that
fun stuff.
So what's the date on that?
I'm thinking this month sometime. My birthday is May 23rd, so my goal is like at least by then.
Sweet.
Because like everything's recorded,
yeah,
mastered. It's just like finalizing these last few details. So
I did have one other question too about your setup. The drums, I'm assuming you basically, because you're a drummer too, so basically, did you record sounds and then put those on your pedals that you did? No comment?
No, all the drums I'm doing live.
Oh,
all
really?
Everything that you heard tonight was all live.
Yeah, I know that. No. I know, but I'm
where
saying,
did you get the sounds from?
The sounds, samples, yeah. Did you record the samples yourself?
The Elesis unit that I'm using had stuff built into it, so... but the cool thing about it is, like, you can plug in an SD card.
Mm-hmm.
So on my computer at home, I got, like, all these, like, Dr. Dre, Eminem drum samples that I haven't even delved into yet. And there's, like, I mean, there's endless samples that you can use. So,
Hey, if you break out some gin and juice, man, that would be fantastic.
Yes.
That would, like, my first band ever covered that song. So nice. Bringing it around full circle. Yeah, shout out to 007, if anyone from that band happens to see this.
007, nice. I was going to say, is the pad, the drum pad, is it sensitive? So the harder you press it, does it?
It is. It's like a piezo.
It kind of
like
felt that,
a little metal thing with like a crystal.
Okay.
And then it's I guess when crystal has like stress on it, it sends out an electrical signal. And that's really, that's all there is to it. Then my buddy Jim Van Fleet just helped wire it up with some quarter inch outputs. And it just worked. We just kind of went for it and.
That's awesome.
That's great, man. That's awesome stuff. Kevin Kramer, everybody. One more time. Make some more noise for him, everybody. Woo! Kevin! Woo!
Thank you.
So we're going to wrap up the podcast here. Do we just want to do the non-judgmental?
Yeah, let's wrap that up. With
we'll just do non-judgmental.
And we'll be done.
We'll be done for...
For a while.
For a little bit anyways. So you never know. We may just all of a sudden spring one on you in a few weeks. You never know. So that's why I say you can't go away. You got to still follow the guys on the radio on Facebook and Twitter and all that other good stuff. So non-judgmental chap, we do things that I am no longer to judge. I'm going to just let it go. I'm going to blow it off and roll it off my chest. I'm no longer going to judge people that do not reply to text messages they get from a wrong phone number. I'm no longer going to judge those people. Did you ever do that before where, like, you send a message to somebody and like, it's not somebody in your phone. It's some, like, a different number, and you think you text the person, and you never hear anything back, and you realize, shit, I sent it to the wrong person. That's why nobody's replying to me.
Did you not see that... thing on Facebook this week? There was a big thing going or flying around about the guy who got the wrong text from the mom thinking she was texting her daughter, and he's like, no, this isn't your daughter, you know, I'm a married man in Wisconsin and you're texting the wrong person. And he starts like sending her pictures of him, and then finally she catches on. She's like, well, I just found my daughter and she was sleeping. I wish, you know. And he's like, I've been telling you the whole time you've been texting the wrong person. Why are you mad at me?
I mean, you know, shouldn't there be a protocol, though, for it? Like, the right thing? Like, just be a nice person and be like, hey, that's not me, but it sounds like fun. Thanks. You know?
It's more fun to leave you in suspense.
I got a message from somebody the other day, and I'm like, what is this? I'm like, did I look at a wrong website or something? Because it seemed like...
What did they send you? That's fun when you get the wrong picture messages.
No, it wasn't a pic. It wasn't a pic. Did I delete the message or not? Let me see if I could find it.
Yeah.
If it was a number... Oh. It was a phone number, an 815 phone number, and it says, this is Jessica Blank. This is my for real new number. And I'm like, hey, Jessica, this is Shap. Not sure this was meant for me.
And she didn't hit you back?
Because, you know, sometimes brides will text us occasionally. Yeah. And I always tell the brides, if you're going to text us, tell us who you are. So that way
we know
who you are. So I'm looking in my records. I'm like, do I know this person? Is she one of our brides? And I never got any message back.
So, well, you have Jessica's real number.
So there you go. Yeah, I got Jessica's
real
number.
Should we call it?
Yeah. You want it? Go ahead. Go ahead. go ahead. Oh, God, you're really going to do this. Do you need a cord?
What's that? It's from Sunday, right?
Mm. Here, you want the cord? You want to plug it in?
No, I don't know. I was gonna put it on speaker.
Oh, you can put it on speaker? You'd watch her be a customer.
Hello, is this Jessica?
Yes.
All right, I got your number from a text message. I just wanted to make sure that I was supposed to have it.
Is this Keith?
No, this isn't Keith. So I'm probably not supposed to have this.
No, sorry.
Oh, okay, sorry about that. We're just double checking.
Are you gonna tell her that you're on a podcast?
Thanks, Jessica. I just want to make sure.
You should have said you were Keith.
Oh, that would have been more
fun. You should have said you were Keith.
You could have played along.
You could have been like, yeah, this is Keith Richards. How you doing?
I was never good at pranking.
Got any heroin or what? Hey.
No. Oh. So, Jessica, you got the wrong number. We're not Keith.
By the way, I almost should we text her right now?
No, that's all right.
Matter of fact, I just bumped my phone and it almost sent. I swear, you know how you turn it sideways and you can do the writing thing? The last one of those I did was to my wife.
Yeah.
And it was love you, and I almost sent her that.
No. Love you.
Love you, Jessica. You're on our podcast.
We're not creepy or stalkers at all.
Oh, Jesus. What the hell are we up to tonight?
I don't know.
This is just awful. I mean,
filth, flarn, filth, flarn, filth.
All right. And
what else you got?
One more non-judgmental. I am not going to judge gas stations who feel the need to charge $2.50 to use their air hose to fill up my tires. That is real.
Yeah.
Like, I've seen $1.25. I've seen $2 in quarters.
In charge for air.
To charge to fill up your tire. Seriously, next time, multiple gas stations.
But you know what they do, though? If you are at least paying the $1.25 for air, they're nice enough to have the nozzles that have the air pressure gauge.
I thought I own one of those. I don't need one of those.
That's kind of nice.
I think I've actually seen ones that charge that don't have that.
No.
Maybe.
That's crazy. But you think about it. You're looking right on the table over here on the other side. You paid for a bottle of water.
I did.
Yes. We pay for bottles of water now. So what's
so
the difference?
So you pay for air.
Exactly. That's the next step up is that, you know, we're going to be Spaceball City pretty soon.
Get it out of a can?
That's right.
So
Evian Air, is that what it was?
This
has been a while.
Something
Spaceballs,
like
anybody? Come on.
Spaceballs 2, the search for more money. So, that's a good one.
Yeah. So, yeah, charging for air. I mean, it's the next evolution from bottled water.
Ludicrous speed. Go. All right.
What's funny is I bet that bottle there, take that bottle of water, because I bet if you look at it, it's probably bottled from a municipal water source. So it's like you're drinking Peru water anyway.
Shut up.
It is. I bet it's bottled. It says it'll say.
Sources, Sanctuary Springs, Rodney, Michigan.
Yeah.
Everett Spring, Everett, Michigan, and or White Pine Spring, Everett, Michigan.
So apparently we can't get clean water in Flint because they're putting it all in that bottle.
I was going to say, I'm just glad. How close are these places to Flint? And I'm just glad
they're
Flint's
stealing
not
all
here
of the municipal water from all these nice
no
water
wonder
sources in Michigan. Flint, I'm sorry.
You're fucked.
You are going to have autism. So that's ridiculous, right? We're all paying because we can afford to buy bottled water from Sanctuary City, but apparently we can't get that water
Sanctuary
to Flint.
Sanctuary City.
So that's the next evolution. Starts with bottled water. The next evolution is going to be buying your air.
All right.
So you're welcome.
Are we ready to be done?
Just deal with it.
Are we finished for the night? Are we done? Are you finally
I'm
ready
done
to stop talking?
I'm done.
All right. I think it's time for us to wrap things up here on the Guys Not on the Radio podcast. Thank you very much, everybody, for tuning, listening, doing it all one more time. Thanks to our in-studio guests, Kevin Kramer. Thanks to our people who tuned in, Bob, May, dude from Kevin's class. Thank you very much. And we'll see you when we see you. And listen to me on 95.3 Jack FM soon. I won't play this, though.
With so much drama in the LBC, it's kind of hard being Snoop D-O-double-G. But I somehow, some way, keep coming up with funky-ass shit like every single day. May I kick a little something for the G's and Make a few ends as I breeze through. 2 in the morning and the party still jumping cause my mama ain't home. I got bitches in the living room getting it on and they ain't leaving till 6 in the morning. So what you wanna do? Shit, I got a pocket full of rubbers and my homeboys do too. So turn off the lights and close the doors. But what?
We don't love them hoes.
Yeah. So we gon' smoke an ounce to this. G's up, hoes down, why you motherfuckers bounce to this?
Rolling down the street, smoking in the mouth, sipping on gin and juice.
Late.